Hello everybody, welcome to the web page example section. In this video, I'm going to show you a simple way of setting up the drop-down menu by using CSS. So this drop-down menu is quite easy. When I simply hover over item 1, you can see that the background color has changed. And when I simply hover over item 2, you can see that I can show the drop-down menu in the form of sub-items on my web page. And I can even press tab key to simply choose the sub-items under the list items, okay? And when I do item 3, okay, you can also see that item 3 has 2 sub-items, and I can also press tab key to do the choosing of the sub-items. Now, let us see the implementation. In order to set up the drop-down menu, I have to use multi-levels of unordered lists. So we can see that I have a navigation link tag, and inside this navigation link tag, I have some unordered lists. Okay, and inside the unordered lists, I have some inner levels of the unordered lists, and the result can be shown on the right-hand side, which is simply a web page. So item 1 has no sub-items, and item 2 has 3 sub-items. So the sub-items are shown in the form of the unordered list inside a particular list element, okay? And for item 3, which is a list element of the outer unordered list, I have some other list elements inside the item 3 list, okay? So I set up some unordered list inside the list item, so you can see the effect in this way. And now I'm going to set up the styles so that it looks like the drop-down menu. So I have to open the CSS file first. Now I'm going to set up the style first. I want to show you the way to change the unordered list elements. Now first, I set up the background color for the unordered lists. So you see for the outer and the inner unordered lists, the background color has turned to a color called pale green. I also removed the bullet points before the list items by setting the list style to be none. Okay, I just want to remove the margins surrounding the unordered list. And now I simply remove the padding on the left-hand side so that the items are placed tightly on the far left of the web page. Then I'm going to set up the styles for the list elements, okay? Now I want to set up the list items to be orange in color. So you see item 1, item 2, and item 3 have turned to orange. Then I'm going to set up the display mode to be the block mode. And I allowed the float style to be on the left hand side. So you see the contents have changed to another format that allows the list elements inside each of the li tag to have the floating style in this way. So every single element shown by the li tag will be placed as left as possible. Then I set up some padding for the list elements. Okay, and you can see that it's, there are some separations between each of the list items. Okay. I set up the position of the list elements to be relative so that the measurements based on the list items can be just based on the position of the particular list elements. Now I want to set up the style when I hover over a certain list element. Okay, the cursor will be in the form of a pointer. So you see when I simply hover over a certain list item, the cursor has turned to the pointer style. Okay, when I set up the sudo class to have a background color of red, when I simply hover over the element, you can see that the background color has turned to red. Same here and same here. So every list item will have a background color of red when I simply hover over them, okay? Now I'm going to set up the style for the unordered list, which is the inner one. So I have to specify the UL first, and then I specify the LI tag, and then I specify the UL tag. So in this order, I'm going to select the unordered list, which is this one and this one. Okay. So when I want to simply select the elements, sub-items 2.1 to 2.3 and sub-item 3.1 and 3.2, I'm going to have some styles for them. For now, I want to hide all the elements of the inner unordered list, and after some future setup, I'm going to show them out in another format, which I'm going to change later. Okay, the position becomes absolute, so you can see that items 1, 2, and 3 are placed on the very top of the web page. Now I set up the margin top to be 1 rem so that you can see the highlighted part being the margin, in order to separate the inner and outer list items that I'm going to show later. The left position of the top margin is set as 0 so that you can see that the highlighted parts are tightly packed. Okay, I don't want to show the inner unordered list items for now, so I simply choose none as the display attribute. Then I'm going to show you the way to let the inner unordered list come out. Okay, when I simply hover over the list item, you can see that the drop-down menu appears. So now the sub-items are visible, and the display mode for these sub-items are set as flex, so that you can see that they are packed together on the horizontal row. Okay, and I can add something more to increase the usability of the web page. Okay, when I set up the focus within sudo class for the LI elements, you can see that I can simply make use of the tab key to choose the items. So let me try it now. Okay, when I hover over item 2, when I press tab. Okay, so let me select the web page first. When I hover over item 2, and then I press the tab key, you can see that I can simply use the tab key to choose the sub-items. So when I just press enter, I'm able to really go to the sub-item 2.3 to see the content coming from this particular hyperlink. Okay, so we can add the purpose of setting up the focus width in sudo class here. Okay, I can allow choosing the unordered list items with the tab key when I just hover the items 2 and 3, and when I simply press tab, I'm able to choose the particular sub-item with the tab key. So that is the idea of the focus within pseudo class. Okay. So the video has already shown you the basic way of setting up the drop-down menu. I have to set up the unordered list styles first, and then I set up the LI element styles, and then I simply control the hover state of the list items, and then I simply hide the original setup of the list items, and then I do the hover and focus within pseudo classes to really see the effects of the drop-down menu in the form of the flex boxes that represent the sub-items. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.